B'nai Torah were always very particular about the kashrus of meat, more than any other type of food. In order for meat to be kosher l'mahadran, many extremely complex halachas must be known.
In order for shechita to be effective, to be at a very high standard of kashrus, one's got to have a foolproof system where, from beginning to end, everything is checked, everything has its place, its time. There's coordination between staff from beginning to end.
In the next few minutes, we will watch the slaughtering at Rav Westheim's and Badat's Igud HaRabbanim slaughterhouse. Together with the Rabbanim, we will take a close look at the smallest details of the kashering process, from the slaughtering to the final packaging. You have the right to know more about the level of kashrus of the meat that you're eating.
Our shechita in Ireland that we set up had as a goal, its tachlis from the beginning was to create a shechita which will satisfy the highest possible standard of medaktikim, machmirim, b'nei Torah, to have a standard of shechita which is second to none. First of all, the team is made up of approximately 13 people every week. Shochtim and Bodkim, who are Talmidei Chachomim, Yirei Shamayim, and the biggest experts we could find in Eretz Yisrael.
Ani b'tchum shel shechita b'ruach Hashem tzalimah mi-20 shana. Mikivan she'anu mitaskim b'shechita mod mod mehudaret, az ze kolel be'etzem bdikat sakinim b'layla shelifnei ha-shechita.
There's no electricity used in bringing them into the Mokim HaShechita, which is important.
The shochtim we have are shochtim vosikim and menusim, shochtim that are Balei Shem, Talmidei Chachamim, Erlich Yidden, people that after the Shechita every day sit and learn.
השחיטה היא מתבצעת כאשר הבהמה מונחת, כאשר היא בעצם מונחת על הגב שלה, ולא כמו במקומות אחרים שהבהמה היא בעצם עם הראש מורם כלפי מעלה. שזה בעצם נותן אפשרויות הרבה יותר רחבות, השחיטה היא הרבה יותר טובה, הרבה יותר מבוקרת, הרבה יותר נכונה.
After the sheikhet has performed the shechita, he doesn't check his chalaf. The sheikhet must not and does not check his own chalaf. There is a bodik sakinim, a person specially appointed whose job is only to check chalafim. The chalaf is checked after every shechita, and in the slightest change in the chalaf, slightest shinui, the chalaf won't be used anymore. Every chalaf must, before each shechita, must be as perfect as it was before the very first animal shechted with the chalaf. There are always two shochtim who work in rotation, and the shochet has every assistance to help him do nothing but the maaseh hashchita, the action of shechita. The cleaning of the neck of the animal is done by an operative of the company. Everything else is done for him. He just has to shecht. That causes the shochet to be very relaxed. There is, in addition to the two shochtim and the bodik sakinim, we have a very eminent moreh roah who is himself an expert shechita bodik, Rav Ephraim Kremizi, which adds another level of security to the kashrus of the shechita. After every five shechitas, the chalaf is dried by the bodik sakinim, and the chalaf is checked dry, which is also very important because sometimes you can feel better a slight problem on the chalaf when it's dry more than when it's wet. A shechita doesn't shecht more than 30-40 minutes at a time, and he's got plenty of time to relax, to shtel his chalofim, so that he doesn't lose his feel of what he's doing. The standard of chalofim is incomparable to a system where one doesn't have a bodik sakinim. it's not just a hidur, it's an absolute must. Those rabbonim who are involved in these kinds of shechitas in the United States or South America all say the same thing. This is a must, a boidik sakinim. After the shechita, the animal goes through the procedure on the line of skinning, etc. There's a mashgiach at the point where the head is removed from the animal to mark the tongue, to number it, and he's in close proximity to the mashgiach who's standing next to the boidkim to make sure that they get the numbers right and the numbers tally. There's a visual and verbal communication between the mashgichim at the main points. We're also careful as the operatives cut open the belly of the animal. We don't allow any saw to be used to cut into the bone. In case the saw may penetrate into the cavity where the lungs are and maybe remove a sircha or cause some problem to the lung. We have a very expert boidikim who not only checks the lungs, but it also checks the hemsis. That's the stomach, one of the stomachs, which is prone to have nails in it, which will make the animal chafe. Even though it's outside the carcass already at that stage, he checks it because it moves together at the same speed as the carcass itself. He writes on a piece of paper where there's a drawing of a lung, exactly at what points he found what problems, which is transmitted to one of two boidkechutz. We have two tables for boidkechutz in order not to cause a pileup of lungs, which will then cause pressure and sometimes panic. And that gives the bodkim the opportunity to do bedika in a very relaxed way with no pressure at all.
The bedika is done by bodkim before samim. Both the boidik pnim and the boidik chutz are incredible talmidei chachamim.
And they check and pass behemoth either as kosher, regular kosher, which is not glatt, or glatt. But we have an extra level, which is chalak beis Yosef, where there are no sirchas and no ririn. Those are the three standards that we have, which gives an added hidur to the beef that comes out of our shechita.
One of the things that we've instituted is, of course, a chalak beis Yosef shechita, which is lemahadrin shemahadrin. Very, very difficult to achieve that if you use a shechita, that have a shechita with a bdika where absolutely no rearing are taken. Baruch Hashem, we've achieved that, and in that basis, it can be considered absolute mahadrin, the mahadrin shechita and bdika.
When the behemoth is pronounced kosher, the cheeks will be sealed by a mashgiach at the end of the line, who seals the cheeks, he'll seal the livers, he'll seal the tongues, and all that is done with constant contact by walkie-talkie with the mashgiach who's standing next to the boidkei chutz and who keeps count of the numbers constantly. And those numbers and that verification is checked twice or three times just to make sure that there are no mistakes. And at the end of the day, the whole list has gone through again. The list that mashgiach has got next, the one who's standing next to the bedikas, against the list that the other mashgiachim have got, and to make sure that there are no mistakes. There's another mashgiach who actually stamps each carcass with a different stamp for glatt, different for chalak bet yosef, and a different stamp for regular kosher. And he's also in constant communication with the mashgiach at the point of the bedikas to make sure that he gets the right stamp on the right animal. It's a system which one can just mention in 5 minutes or 10 minutes, but it took many months of a lot of thought and input to achieve the system which we have today, which is really second to none. Once the beef has passed all the veterinary inspection, it's taken to a very large fridge, and they are hung in different rows, again, different rows for glatt, for chalak beis Yosef and kosher, and they are subjected to the process of nikkur. We do a full nikkur on the forequarter as the animal is hanging, with experts, mumchim, to the top level of diktuk that can be. The beef is then taken to the shriya and melicha, to the soaking, pre-salt soaking, and the salting, and then the post-soaking. There's a mashgiach with another operative who makes sure to get rid of all the dam be'en, all visible dam, which could not be taken off at the point of nikur because it's hanging too low, will be removed at that point. The chalak bis Yosef goes into the water first. There's then a gap of half an hour before the regular glatt goes in, and a gap of another half an hour before the regular kosher goes in. So there's such a separation of time, and the water is moving the whole time in a contraflow. So therefore the water in which the regular glatt enters will never come into contact with the chalak bis Yosef. That's an extra hidur, an extra precaution, which we've had for a long time now. The melicha is done to a perfection which is hard to find in other places. With a lot of thought and a lot of input, we've managed to get it to a point where the meat is 100% covered with salt and the melicha is really muhderes other tachlis. The beef is hanging on the line, which takes a whole hour to go round, and then it enters the area where it's going to get washed off. There's first a shower to get rid of the salt, which is niputz, and then it automatically is dipped into three consecutive soak tanks where it has a hadocha achoina three times. So again, that's a hidur to have a niputz and three hadochas, and after that the kosher gemachte fleisch without any dam be'en, perfectly clean, comes out and is ready for boning and packing. Now what's important to note is that the boning and packing is done in a room where it's not possible for any non-kosher meat to come in. The boning is done with our own knives on our own tables. They're boxed in front of two mashgichim, and these mashgichim make sure that the right labels are put on for the meat that's in the box. Everything is sealed three times, really. We've got a seal on the bag inside the box, and we've got two seals on the outside of the box to make sure that it's clearly identified as a kosher product, and the seals are made specially in such a way that they cannot tear in transit. So from beginning to end, there's a whole chain of events which make sure that the product that comes out is guaranteed to be 100% kosher, without any doubt, without any pikpukim, which is to the highest standard that any medaktik, any ben toira, any elach yid, ayei shemayim, could wish for.
Chalak Beit Yosef, lemaaseh, zeh basar shehayu tzirchim kulam leechol, והרבנים שעוזרים לרב גרוס הם כולם מאוד בקיאים ומשורתים מאוד טובים. אז אני חושב שהדבר הזה יש לו עתיד גדול.
האמת הוא שלפי ראות עיניי, אני רואה בשחיטה הזאת מהפכה חדשה שיש בשחיטה באירופה. כל אחד ואחד בפני עצמו, כל שוחט, כל בודק, הוא מומחה בפני עצמו. בוודאי ברור לי שמכוח השחיטה הזאת זה יעורר שבכל המקומות יוכלו להעמיד את השחיטה באופן הנעלה.
Another important point about the shechita is that we've always operated an open policy. As contrary to some people who are afraid for visitors coming to the shechita, we are open. Anybody, any rov, any serious-minded rov is invited with open arms to come to see. There are no secrets, nothing hidden. We're happy for anybody to come anytime.
I felt by the shechita over there, it was open, and it is open to other people who want to come, who want to see it. It's not closed. Anybody would like to see, give any ha'oros to the shochtim, want to ask something, will be answered. It's a shechita which a teuerdige crowd can be proud of, that they can be able to access such kind of meat from such a mehudedige shechita.
Tzevet ha'shochtim v'tzevet ha'botkim, המידות טובות שלהם, העירת שמיים מרבים שלהם, באומנות שלהם, בדקתי את האומנות בבדיקת הסכין, האומנות במעשה השחיטה, האומנות בבדיקת ריאות, בדיקת חוץ ופנים. כמובן, הכל על פי ההוראות של ידידי הגאון, רב משה ינקה וסטהיים שליט"א, שהוא תמיד חכם ופוסק ידוע, ומומחה גדול בכשרות, כמו שיודעים אלו שמתמצים בעולם הזה של הכשרות.
Over the many times that I've been at this particular shechita, I've seen have got the system down to an absolute fine art. We have top shochtim, top bodkim. Everybody knows their role. Everyone's in contact with one another. Everyone's supportive of one another. And in that way, it's not only ourselves who give the hechsher, but all the other various authorities and rabbonim who give the hechsher are people who know the trade, who understand kashrus, understand kosher, and have brought it up to a real top level of kashrus and shechita lemahadrin.
A lot of times I get calls from my chaverim, you know, it's Sorel Heinte, Rosh HaKoylem, Rosh Yeshivist, and they ask me about the shechita. I tell them, this is a shechita for you. This is a shechita for Bnei Torah. This is a shechita for Talmidei Chachamim. We can bring the Gresta Makbid, and he will be impressed. And all I can say is that I am very proud to be associated with the shechita.
Vaday shacheridim al dvar Hashem v'amedagdekim bekashrut v'amakpidim beshechita kedat v'kedin. Vaday sheicholim leechol me'ashechita muderet hazot bli shum chashash v'bli shum pikpuk.
The features that we added in this shechita, although I maybe have called them hidurim, but they're not hidurim. Some of them are absolutely essentials in having a proper lechatchila de keshchita. Together with all the other factors we put in place to guarantee such a high level of kashrus, are the vital ingredients to produce a product which is fit and suitable for the most stringent medaktikim and yirei shamayim, and that is really what they should strive for, to have meat with these standards only.